I've always been concerned about our planet since I was a child. I studied environmental engineering because I wanted to save the world. And I moved into the water sector because of an opportunity to work at the intersection of water, energy, and climate. My colleague Paul Kadota came back from a conference all excited about hydrothermal liquefaction. He'd met a researcher who was doing HTL of algae, and Paul thought, let's use sludge instead.
This is our largest plant of our five plants in the region.
And what's the population that you serve?
We serve 2.8 million. It's a lot of tons. I think we were looking at 50,000 tons, and now we still have two primary treatment plants. And now as we're moving those into secondary and tertiary, our tonnages are coming right up, they're doubling.
Sludge is better because we don't have to grow algae or a crop. You know, sludge is produced at our treatment plants every day. So the idea of turning sludge into fuel was really exciting.
It's something new, it's a new concept, it's gonna offer us new ways to manage our solids into the future.
Communities everywhere are struggling with what to do with biosolids. They're facing tighter regulations, environmental concerns, lots of pressures.
The way we manage our wastewater, our current treatment processes are not enough.
So HTL offers a solution where they can turn that burden into a valuable resource.
Making sure that we get the most out of every single drop that gets flushed down a toilet, and that its impact on the environment is minimized.
Every day, I walk into site, and I'm thinking, wow, we are turning wastewater into fuel. That's science fiction right there. I'm a lead senior engineer at Metro Vancouver. I'm the project manager tasked to deliver the first hydrothermal liquefaction demonstration plant. One of the biggest challenges with the hydrothermal liquefaction is that all of a sudden we were dealing with technology that is not common for wastewater engineers.
So sludge is dewatered, and then it's brought up to a high temperature, high pressure, and in a matter of 15 to 30 minutes, it's converted into three products. The first one, and the traditionally highest value, is biocrude.
WRF arranged a bench scale test of HTL at Pacific Northwest National Lab using sludge from this treatment plant from Anisus Island. They ran it through their HTL process, and when I first saw a jar of biocrude, it looked exactly like crude oil, and that's a resource that refineries want to help make low carbon fuels. Knowing that it came from sludge felt magical and possible.
We can spend less, we can recycle or reuse existing infrastructure, and we can start making renewable fuels faster and with a lower, you know, total carbon intensity.
There's a lot of challenges in being the first in terms of, you know, design, construction. How are we going to actually build this thing?
So I had to build a team, bringing in experts from all these fields to be able to deliver this project.
One of the first things that we developed was this kind of phased process for evaluating, testing its chemical nature, if it's corrosive or not, and what kind of metallurgy you need to store it in.
There are solutions for the byproducts. They might not come from within our own sector. They're coming from oil and gas. They're coming from pharmaceuticals.
We've taken the co-processing route, which really lets us use all the infrastructure and technologies that we've already built here in the refinery. We converted one tank and one pipeline to start bringing in renewable feeds, and, you know, away we go.
So it's been a long road to get here, but knowing that the first pieces of this HTL demonstration are being fabricated.
Wastewater is now an opportunity.
We're creating a generational asset here.
Being better stewards of how we treat it means that everyone gets to enjoy the efforts that we're putting in here.
I got a feeling it'll be here for a while.
We're going to be able to prove it out. It could unlock the potential for other utilities. With innovation, everyone is waiting for someone else to go first. And in this case, we get to go first.